could move a little closer together, that way we can fit a few more people in. Thank you.
Amy, is the balcony full? Hi. But there is some room up on the side. Yes. What? There's some up on the side of the altar. There's some seating up on the side of the altar. Okay, just wherever the children's choir is going to sit. I should have had Brian set up chairs, but I didn't know. Okay, guys, let's go.
No.
I mean, yeah, I don't know. Maybe they have large families. Okay, guys, let's go. There may be some room also up in the... Thank you. of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us bless this water and remind ourselves of our baptism. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Almighty, ever-living God, who willed that through water the fountain of life and the source of purification, even souls should be cleansed and receive the gift of eternal life, be pleased, we pray, to bless this water, by which we seek protection on this your day, O Lord. Renew the living spring of your grace within us, and grant that by this water we may be defended from all ills of spirit and body, and so approach you with hearts made clean, and worthily receive your salvation. Through Christ our Lord. God, cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. Gloria in
in excelsis Deo.
Et in terra pax hominibus, bene voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias agibus tibi, propter magnam gloriam tuam, Domine Deus rex celestis, Deus Pater omnipotens, Domine fili unigenite, Jesu Christe, Domine Deus agnus Dei,
gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving, for the ascension of Christ your Son is our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which you have heard me speak. For John baptized you with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, they were looking on. He was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight, while they were looking intently at the sky as he was going. Suddenly, two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you spirit and wisdom of revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call. What are the riches of glory, and his inner tents among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe in according to the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at the right hand of the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, in every name that is named, not only in his age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet, and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is body, the fullness of one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations beginning from Jerusalem. You are witness of these things. And behold, I am sending the promise of my Father upon you, but stay in the city until you are clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, raised his hands, and blessed them. As he blessed them, he departed from them and was taken up to heaven. They did him homage and then returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple praising God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Well, boys and girls, this is a very, very special day. And I can tell you, you guys must be extremely well loved, because in all the years that we've had First Communion here while I've been here, we've never ran out of seats. And today was the first time. So you guys must have lots of people who love you and have come to celebrate this day with you. But we celebrate this weekend three very important things. What's the first thing we're celebrating? Who can tell me? That's right, First Communion. What's the second thing we're celebrating? Mother's Day. That's right. And the third, can anyone guess? Well, yes, there's a party. Yes, that's always good. Yes. Well, no, not quite summer vacation. It's a religious thing. Yes. Do what? Okay. Yes. No, well, you're close. Body and blood. No, not Memorial Day. Come on, guys, you know. Nope, that's coming up. It begins with an A. I'll give you a clue. Ascension, that's right, Michael. The ascension of Jesus. So we're celebrating three very important things today. The first is, today is the Feast of the Ascension. Now, what does it mean to ascend? Who can tell me, what does it mean to ascend? That's right, you rise up into heaven. So here was Jesus, he was with his disciples, that, you know, he had died, he'd risen from the dead, and he'd been telling them that, okay, guys, I'm getting ready, I'm going to leave. I'm going to go back up to heaven, and now you're going to have to do the work, and you're going to have to carry on the mission that we've started here. So he takes them out, as we heard in the Bible, to Bethany. Not Bethany, Oklahoma, but Bethany over by Jerusalem. And Bethany is at the top of what is called the Mount of Olives, which is a little, it's really not a mountain, it's kind of a huge big hill, right outside of Jerusalem. He takes them up on top of that, and then like we heard in the gospel, he raised his hands and he ascended and went up into heaven. Now, that was not a sight that anyone had ever seen before, all right? So what do you think was going through the disciples' mind when they saw that happen? Yes. Whoa, that's right, that's right. At school mass, someone said, holy moly, yes. So I'm sure they thought, whoa, there he goes, right up into the sky. If I did that, you would wonder, he's got wires or something doing that. But no, Jesus didn't have that. So he went up into heaven, and then all of a sudden, there they were. They didn't have Jesus there anymore. And so, what was their job now that Jesus was gone? Yes. That's right, to keep praying, yes. Yeah. That's right, to spread the good news. And so they had a job to do, and now they were on their own. Well, boys and girls, First Communion is kind of like that to some extent. Not that you're going to be ascending or something like that. But Jesus left the disciples with his body and blood and with his words. And so he left them with what they needed to be disciples and carry out his mission. And so you guys too, and all of us here, all of us, through our baptism, we're called to be disciples, just like they were. Now, you know, we're going to not do it, like we don't have to walk around from town to town and, you know, preach and things like that. But we're disciples. How can we be good disciples? Those of us, yes, we can pray, be nice to others.
Go to Mass.
Certainly, go to Mass, yes. Go to Mass every day, that'd be wonderful, yes. Help the poor, very good, yes. Teach about Jesus. Love God. Share with the homeless. Plant a tree or help a family, yes. Go to confession, that's right. Be a priest, yes. Someone needs to do that, I'm getting old, yes. Feed the homeless. So boys and girls, you know what it means to be a disciple. And hopefully all of these grown-ups were listening to these things too, because all of us are called to be disciples. And so Holy Communion, you know how when you were little, well, your mom would say, you got to eat this or that, and it makes you strong? And it usually wasn't ice cream or chocolate, was it? No. What does your mom and dad usually say you have to eat to make you strong?
Broccoli.
Broccoli, yes. Lettuce, yes, yes. Brussels sprouts, yes. Cabbage, meat, peas, spinach, fruits and vegetables, all right. So boys and girls, yes, our parents tell us, and it's right, we eat all those things, lettuce, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, all those things. Do they taste very good? No, probably not. But they help us grow strong. Well, you are going to receive the body and blood of Jesus Christ, and that will help you to grow strong in your faith. And I promise you, it tastes a lot better than broccoli or Brussels sprouts, okay? And remember, this is actually the body of Christ. And the wine becomes the blood of Christ. And remember, like we practiced, you know, you just take a little bit of it, but each time you do that, you're receiving Jesus' body and blood. So this, we celebrate Ascension. And also this weekend, we celebrate First Communion. So that's a very awesome thing. How many of you are excited about First Communion? All right, everyone's excited. How many grown-ups are excited about communion? Okay, good, yes. Because sometimes we're all excited about our First Communion and then it kind of goes after that, then we're not quite as excited. But we should be excited every single time. When I was a priest living in Rome, I said Mass for some sisters, and they had a little sign in their sacristy, which is the little room where we get dressed, and this sign said, "Dear priest, celebrate this Mass as if it was your first Mass, your last Mass, and your only Mass," which means each time you do it, it's extra special. So celebrate First Communion like it's your first time, and like it's your second time, and like it's your last time, okay? Because if you do that, then you remember how special it is. And the third thing we celebrate this weekend is what? Uh-oh, if you forget, you're going to be in the doghouse. Mother's Day, that's right. And what a blessing that Holy Communion comes on Mother's Day. And why are our mothers special? What makes... They give us stuff we want. Some do, some don't. They give us what we need, yes. Some do give us ice cream, yes. They take care of us. That's right, they tell us about Jesus Christ. Yes, let's get someone over here, yes. They love you, yes. They take care of you. They let you watch TV, yeah, yeah. You forgot, okay, yes. They had you, yes. No. They pay for things, yes. Until you grow up, then they don't, yes. They do your laundry till you grow up, then they don't, okay, yes. They do, they make you your food. So boys and girls, our mothers take care of us, they love us, and they help us to be who we are. And they too teach us about faith, and they too teach us how to love. And so boys and girls, this is a wonderful day because you're getting to receive the body and blood of Jesus Christ on the day that he ascended up into heaven, and then we also honor our mothers. And so this is a beautiful day. And let us thank the Lord for the wonderful gifts that he has given to us. And now we are going to give our mothers a special blessing. So if all the mothers would stand up, we'll give them a special blessing. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth and grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound love and respect. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's give our mothers a round of applause.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now let us bring our prayers to the Lord.
For the church, that we may fulfill the commission given by Jesus to proclaim the good news of God's forgiveness to all of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, that God will inspire them with courage and new understanding as they strive to establish just and humane treatment for immigrants and refugees, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who spread the good news, particularly missionaries, preachers, and writers, that God will inspire them to announce God's love and presence to all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are graduating this spring, that God will help them pursue their dreams and make a difference in our society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who face the future with fear or apprehension, that God will give them courage and peace to follow Jesus each day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers and all who have been like mothers to us, that God will bless and strengthen them and inspire us to great love by their witness of their love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of our beloved departed, especially Bridget McKay, Mary Ann Normandy, Martha Laughlin, and for all who grieve their loss, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silent prayer, let us now mention our own special intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we ask you to hear these prayers and those that we hold in our hearts. Continue to show us your mercy and your love, and we ask this all through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts. He ascended, not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we as members might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they proclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all those who are holding on to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true, celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, our Lord, placed at the right hand of your glory our weak human nature, which he had united to himself, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family,
Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, and through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. We remember especially Florence Haddon. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now we come to a special part of our First Communion Mass where we give our First Communion students their certificates, or their, we won't call it a diploma because they're not graduating from the church, but your initiation into the full church. So as I call your name out, just come forward. Danica Allen. Anglin Campbell. Ashlyn Beasley. Samuel Beasley. Laura Brown San Juan. Wyatt Burglar, Bugler. Presley Cates. Amelia Chambers. Elizabeth Chanson. Malachi Connolly. John Coyle, or Jack Coyle. Liliana Curie. Blake Duran. Patrick Flynn. Zachary Flores. Bella Foster. Michael Gaspera. Vera Hansen. Benjamin Holman. Mason Hong. Blair Hauser. Cole Humbert. Nicole Jackson. Congratulations. McKellen Johnson. Anna LaForge. Noah Lips. Reese Love. Seth Lucky. Samuel Margo. Quinn Martin. Avery McIntyre. Carson McMurtry. Annie Merrill. Madison Muskowski. Baylor Moats. Joseph Mosser. Rachel Paul. Rush Roberts. Lucy Rosenhammer. Corbin Sanders. Timothy Shanahan. Caroline Shaw. Dylan Sims. Jackson Stanton. Angelina Stidham. Luke Strickland. Tanner Sullivan. Alexander Valerio. Beatrice Ward. Grayson Ward. Elijah Webb. Andrew Whitmarsh. Samuel Whitmarsh. And Angela Williams. Boys and girls, it's been a great pleasure to be able to give you your first Holy Communion. And we certainly hope it's one of many, many, many. And you know, the thing that is, as I look out on all of you and see your names, I realize I've been here long enough now that probably about 90% of you I baptize. And so that's kind of cool. And the thing that really makes me old, feel old, is I realize that there's a couple of you that I gave your parents their first communion. So at any rate, any time does fly. So. Your first communion will hear, and then you'll have your 10,000th before you know it. So again, may God bless you all. Have you ever been at one of those things that you think, when will it ever end? Well, this is it. Now we have announcements. You're all invited to a reception in the atrium afterwards where there's cake and punch. I know many of you have plans, but at least stop by for a few moments. Our mothers are invited, if the ushers have done their duty, to take a carnation, a flower, that we have for you near the doors in honor of Mother's Day. Also, junior high students are invited to youth group tomorrow evening at 6:30. Our St. Anne's Society for new and expectant mothers is bringing Janice Connell, a well-known speaker, to Christ the King this Tuesday, May the 10th, but the whole parish is invited. She is a well-known expert on Mary and the angels. There is a dinner and a presentation, and it is at 7 p.m. on Tuesday. You can RSVP online, and there's more information in the bulletin. In honor of the Year of Mercy, I will hear confessions this Thursday from 5:30 to 6:30. The Women's Prayer Breakfast is this Tuesday, May the 10th at 7 a.m., and Mary Diane Steltenkamp will be the speaker. Altar servers who are going on the Six Flags trip should be sure to return your forms and payment by this Friday, May 13th. If you haven't received one, please call the office. Our annual street party is next Sunday, May 15th. There's a required waiver for children to play in the inflatables in this week's bulletin on page 6. If you weren't able to bring your donations for the Mother's Day diaper drive, you may bring them to the parish office during this coming week. And lastly, I'd just like to thank all of those who helped make this day possible, our second grade classroom teachers, our second grade RE teachers, our RE director and her assistants. I'm not naming names because I'll forget someone. Our wonderful choir, our children's choir, the servers, and all, thank you for making such a beautiful celebration. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.